Let's learn about network stack trace today. We have a button here and I'm going to just click on that. And now in the network tab, we can see that this created two API calls, two initiator requests. So maybe that looks wrong. We expected it to do only one API call, but how do we debug it from here? So in your network tab, go to this column called initiator. Now it shows HTTP utils, and if you hover over that, it shows a card which says that okay, this request was triggered by HTTP utils, which was called by repos.js, which in turn was called by homecomponent.js. Now maybe in a home component looks like the component which is actually triggering the request. And now on the left, we can also see which method in that file created the API request. We can just hover over this and click on the file name, which will take us to the source code in the file. Now here, if you see, it seems like we are calling fetch repos twice, which is of course wrong. We can just go ahead and delete the first line. That should fix our problem. So in Gist, network stack trace allows you to find that given an API call, which component or method or file was responsible for triggering that API call.